Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a video on my favorite liquid lipsticks, my favorite and my least favorite liquid lipsticks. So this is going to be kind of like a battle of the liquid lipsticks. I'm going to show you different companies and give you mini reviews on each company and kind of compare them in price, how long they wear, if they are pigmented, all that kind of stuff, if they come off while you're eating, etc. like that. So I have six different ones to compare, and yeah, let's get started. So like I said, this is going to be like a battle of the liquid lipsticks. I love liquid lipsticks. I wear them like all the time because I like the benefit that they don't budge, that they stay on your lips and they don't slide around and you can eat with them. And I just really like liquid lipsticks because it like sticks to your lips. I'm actually wearing a liquid lipstick right now. I love liquid lipsticks. They last throughout the day. You don't have to touch them up usually, so that's why I like them. Also, stay tuned to the end because I have a surprise. So the first company I have is Anastasia Beverly Hills. I have about five of these shades, five or six of them, and they are on more of the pricey side. They sell for $20 a pop. And you can find them on Macy's website as well as Anastasia Beverly Hills website. I believe they are also on Ulta's website, I think. So I'll put that all in the description box below so you can see. This one is in the shade Sorbet. I am not a fan of this shade because it's way too light for me. But otherwise, I really like the Anastasia Beverly Hills ones. They are super pigmented. They last throughout the day. Depending on, I have seen some reviews of them where they aren't as pigmented or they kind of rub off. For me, they've been so great and I have loved, loved, loved them. They are on the pricier side, so that's why I don't have a very wide range of them because they are kind of expensive in my opinion. I don't know. I really like them, but if you're looking to stay on the cheaper side, I would kind of stay away from these. But they are super pigmented. They do last a really long time, not just on your lips for wearability, but also in the tube because you get a nice amount of product. For $20, you get 0.11 ounces of this lip color. And it comes in this glass container, glass or very awesome plastic container, and it has a doe foot applicator, which I really like. I think those are really nice for liquid lipsticks. This one lasts throughout the day. I don't have to really reapply this one. Once I put it on my lips, it kind of stays for a few hours and I don't have to worry about touching it up. I have also tested this out with eating like greasier foods or foods that have more oil in them, and my lips haven't really budged at all, so that's been really good. I do like this as far as high-end liquid lipsticks go. I do really like them. I just tend not to buy as many because they are so expensive. The next company that I have is NYX. Now NYX has these liquid matte, these soft matte lip creams, so they are the liquid lipsticks. They do dry matte to your lips. The one I have right here is Stockholm. It's like a neutrally shade. These sell for about $5.99. I believe they come in a very wide variety of shades. These are more of a thinner consistency. They aren't super, super pigmented, but they are able to be layered. You can layer these on, so if you do two or three coats, you're pretty much good to go. And I really like these as far as drugstore or drugstore priced items go. I think these are actually really, really good because they're super cheap. I do think they're a little bit drying to the lips. They are more on the dry side. So if you're looking for something that's a little bit more moisturizing, this is definitely not it, like, at all. But I do think that they are definitely worth the price because they're only $6. And I think in the NYX one is 0.27 fluid ounces. Pigmentation is actually really, really good, as long as you layer it up. And as far as eating foods and it coming off, it has not for me, so it's been really, really good. These last pretty much throughout the day, and I think they hold up to, if you layer them, they kind of have the same effect as the Anastasia Beverly Hills ones, so definitely check these out. Next company I have is LA Splash. I have their Smitten Lip Tints. I have about four or five of these, I believe. They all are, the ones at least I have, they are all Harry Potter themed, so that's kind of why I liked them, because they all have Harry Potter names. This is the one called Love Good, and I really like this, again, with my Neutrally Pink shades. I have a lot of those. These retail for $12.98, or are they $11.98? They retail for $11.98. In the LA Splash one, this is, how many ounces is this? I'll actually put right here how many ounces that is. I will look it up because it doesn't say it on the package. And so these actually are some of my favorites, not just because of the names, but because they are super, super long wearing. I really like them. I don't feel like they're super drying to my lips, so that's a really good thing. And I do not have to touch these up very much at all, so I like those. If you're looking for something that's comparable to Anastasia Beverly Hills, but just a bit cheaper, definitely check these out. I will link them in the description box below as well. I will link all these in the description box below so you can see them. And if you want to check these out, they are really, really good. Like I said, $12. They're long lasting, long wearing. They don't flake off and they're not super drying to your lips, which I really like. I like the more moisturizing ones, not glossy ones. I still like them to dry matte, but the ones that are not like super drying where you feel like your face is going to like flake off. So the next one that I have, I actually do not have a picture of it in my hand. I don't have an example of it in my hand. I will put a picture right here. And these are the Stila All Day Liquid Lipsticks. These sell for about $24. I will also include the fluid ounces right here so you can see it. And these are super, super moisturizing. I have one of the shades and I really, really like it. The shade Fiery, which is like a deep red. It's really super moisturizing to your lips. Not super moisturizing. It's really moisturizing to your lips. It's not on the drier side, so I do like that about it. I do think these last throughout the day. I haven't had a problem with them really flaking off, except for if I do try to layer these too much, layer the Stila ones too much, they do tend to last a little bit shorter amount of time. But if I don't layer them up, then they last a decent amount of time throughout the day and I don't have to touch them up. They are super pigmented. They are pricier than Anastasia Beverly Hills. They are $24. They are the most expensive out of this group. So that is why I only have one or two of them, because I don't want to spend $24 on a liquid lipstick. I just cannot bring myself to do that. But if you have a little bit extra money and you want to check these out, Stila ones are actually really, really good. They are long wearing, they're pigmented, they don't flake off, that kind of thing. They're really good, you should check them out. They are just on the pricier side. One that I have is ColourPop. I have an example right here. I actually have a couple more downstairs where my vanity is. This is in the shade Vice. This is super, super light. I got this one way too light for me. And as far as the ColourPop ones go, for pigmentation, they're not really that pigmented if you are going for the lighter ones. I would suggest going for the darker shades in this collection because the lighter ones tend to flake off. You definitely can't layer any of them. And they are not as pigmented in my opinion. They just definitely did not work for me. I would go for the darker shades. The darker shades that I do have in the ColourPop ones are actually really good and those are great. And I've gotten more used to them now. They are super, super drying. If you're not looking for a liquid lipstick that is drying, do not go with these. They are super, super, super drying. And if you do not like darker shades, I would kind of pass on these too. They are $6, so they are the cheapest out of all of them. They are the same price as the NYX liquid matte lip creams, but I think the NYX ones are a bit better because you don't really have to worry about them flaking off. You don't have to worry about layering them up. And with ColourPop, you cannot layer these. It's like one swipe, that's it. And it's going to be super drying. So while these are pretty decent if you're looking for something that's cheap, I would go with the NYX ones over these. I did a separate video on the ColourPop ones. Wasn't the greatest fan. I've gotten more used to them now. I like the darker shades better. I think those are better wearing, but these light shades, man, no, just stay away from them. And the last brand that I have is, of course, Kat Von D. I love me some Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. They are definitely some of my favorites. I just absolutely love them. The fluid ounces on this is 0.22 fluid ounces. For that, you get all of this. I have the shade right here, Lolita, that is also the shade that's on my lips. I've had this shade on my lips since early this morning and it has not come off whatsoever. I really, really like this. These, I feel like you can layer, you can like really put them on top of each, like you can put a couple coats and you're not gonna have to worry about it flaking off. This one is not super drying, but my other one that I do have from Kat Von D, the Outlaw one, the red one, that is really drying on my lips. I don't know why. It's super, super drying. But the Lolita one, which I think is one of the most popular ones, it is not super drying, and it's just awesome all around. I just absolutely, absolutely love it. The expensive side of things, for sure, but they last you a very long time. I've had this Lolita one for quite some time, and I still have not gone all the way through it. It also has a doe foot applicator. Actually, all of these do. Don't all these have a doe foot applicator? I do not have a problem with it flaking off or being super drying to my lips. I actually don't even feel that it's on my lips, and I really, really love it. I love it, and this pigmentation on these are so great. I know that she just came out with some new shades in this line, and they are fabulous. I don't know. I love Kat Von D. As far as my most favorite one, it's definitely Kat Von D. Out of all of these, I like Kat Von D's the most, but I also like the LA Splash ones and the NYX ones as well. So those are really good ones too. I would definitely try to look around. If you're looking for cheaper ones, definitely go with NYX. And if you're fine with spending more, go with Stila or Kat Von D. Anastasia Beverly Hills is also a good one, but I kind of like Kat Von D a little bit better than the Anastasia ones. And they're just like pretty. Like, look at these packaging for these. They're just gorgeous. So I'm kind of a sucker for packaging, and while Anastasia Beverly Hills, the packaging is actually pretty nice, I think, oh, I almost stabbed myself in the eye, I think the Kat Von D ones are even prettier, so. So anyway, hope you guys like this video. Now on to my giveaway portion. So I'm going to be doing a mini giveaway in this video because I feel like I haven't done a giveaway in a while. I also haven't celebrated the 3,000 subscriber mark, and that's coming up soon. That's not this giveaway. That'll come up soon. That'll be a bit bigger than this giveaway. But I'm just going to do a mini giveaway this time. And this time I'm going to be actually giving away a Kat Von D liquid lipstick. It's going to be in the shade Lovesick, which is like a mauve-y nude color. I figured that would be a good color to give away because it looks good on most shades. And to enter this giveaway, you of course have to be subscribed to me. You have to be subscribed to me and comment below what your favorite liquid lipstick is. That could be anything. It could be drugstore, high-end, whatever. Just make sure to put the name, the brand, and also the name of the shade that you like, because I am looking for some new liquid lipsticks to try out next month. I am on a no buy this month, but next month is my birthday month, so I'm gonna be buying another liquid lipstick. Maybe not all of them, but something. So I'm looking for something. It will last for 2 weeks as always. I am actually going to make a giveaway winner video in 2 weeks. So this giveaway will last for 2 weeks until Saturday, October 10th. On October 11th, that is a Sunday, I will announce the winner via a giveaway winner video because I realize that most people don't check back on the videos to see if they've won. So I'm going to start doing the videos again where I say the winner. Anyway, like I said, this giveaway will last until October 10th. So you have 2 weeks to enter, and then the winner will be announced that Sunday, and I will be shipping out that Monday. So if you are the winner, please inbox me your address, and I can get that shipped out right away. Anyway, so I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it so much. If you haven't already, please thumbs up this video if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Don't forget to just be yourselves. I love you guys so much. I've had a lot of coffee today. Can you tell? Bye!